The recent disappearance of Malaysian Airlines flight MH370 makes me think, can we really lose a plane with the technology we have today? To answer this question, let's study how an airplane is normally tracked. The ATC, Air Traffic Control, monitors the airspace using two radars, primary and secondary. The primary radar can detect and report position of anything that reflects its transmitted radio signals, including aircraft, birds, weather, land features, etc. Its targets don't have to cooperate, they only have to be within its coverage to be able to reflect the radio waves. This radar only indicates the position of the targets, but does not identify them. Today, the primary radar is just used as a backup or complementary system to the secondary radar. This new radar relies on targets equipped with a transponder. The transponder is a radio receiver and transmitter, which receives on one frequency, 1030 MHz, and transmits on another, 1090 MHz. Along with the positions of the target, the secondary radar can request the altitude as well as the identity of the aircraft using the IFF, the Identification Friend or Foe System. Also, by monitoring successive transmissions, the speed and direction of the aircraft can be determined. But once an aircraft is more than 240 kilometers or 150 miles out to sea, radar coverage fades away. The only way ATC keeps in touch with the aircraft is high-frequency radio. So the answer is, yes, we can lose a plane with the technology we have today. But wait, what about GPS? The aircraft uses GPS to show pilots their position on the map, but this data is usually not shared with ATC. Anything else? Well, there's this new technology called ADSB, which means Automatic Dependent Surveillance Broadcast. ADSB will help the aircraft to determine its position using GPS and relay the data to the ground and other planes. Unfortunately, as of now, only 65% of all passenger aircraft are equipped with ADSB. The last option to track a plane in case of a plane crash is the black box or flight recorder. Each recorder has a device fitted to it known as an underwater locator beacon or ULB. The device is activated as soon as the recorder comes into contact with water, and it can transmit from a depth as deep as 14,000 feet. And the maximum detection range for a 10 kHz transponder is 17 to 22 kilometers in good conditions. Also, to help investigators find them, a black box is not actually black at all, but bright orange. Hey, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, then hit the subscribe button below, or follow the Curious Engineer on Twitter. Also, check out this sweet channel for other cool science videos.